life cycle of natum, natum systematic position, natoxida, sorry, natophyta, natoxida, natales and natacea distribution represented by 40 species confirmed to tropical and humid regions. According to Bhardwaj in 1957, mainly 5 natum species in India. Natum nimon, shrubby plant found in Assam, Naga Hills region. Natum contractum, succulent shrub found in Kerala and Nilgiri Hills. Natum latifolium, climber found in Andaman and Nicobar and Natum ula, woody climber with swollen nodal branches, locality, regions of Kerala, Andhra Pradesh, Orissa. Natum monastrum, climber with slender branches woven at nodes, locality Assam, Sikkim and parts of Orissa. This is the photograph of natum. Characteristic features of natum. Most species are climber except few being shrubs and trees. Branches two types, branches of limited growth and branches of unlimited growth. Climbing species have branches of limited growth, short shoot and unbranch with foliage leaves. Leaves dicot like scale leaves, large and oval with entire margins. 9 to 10 in pairs, arranged in decussate fashion with reticulate venation. These are the leaves of natum. Anatomy of natum root. In young root, layer of starch filled cortical cells, 4 to 6 layer of pericycles. Root may be diarch and exarch as angiospermic character. In older root, primary xylem indistinguishable due to secondary growth, consists of tracheid vessels and xylem parenchyma. Phloem consists of sieve tubes, phloem parenchyma. Bars of sanio present in tracheids, absent in vessels. Stem, in young stem, which resembles typical dicot stem, sunken stomata present, cortex, few layer of chlorenchymatous cells, few layers of parenchymatous cells, and few layers of sclerenchymatous cells, endodermis and pericycle indistinguishable, vascular bundles are conjoined, collateral, open and endarched in ring, xylem comprises tracheids and xylem vessel, phloem comprises sieved cells and phloem parenchyma. In old stem, primary cambium short-lived, sclerotic cells are present, secondary cambium in different part of cortex form a ring. Secondary wood comprises tracheids and vessels. Phloem sieve cells have oblique perforated sieve plates. Medullary rays consist of polygonal parenchyma cells. Leaves. They resemble dicot leaves with cuticularized epidermis. Stomata on both sides except on veins. Mesophyll differentiated into single-layer palisade. Well-developed spongy parenchyma. Stone cells and latex tube present in midrib region. Vascular bundles are curved form in midrib region. Conjoined, collateral and or type of vascular bundle. Xylem tracheid vessels and xylem parenchyma are present. Phloem sieve cells and phloem parenchyma are present. Reproduction in natum. Natum is dioecious, cones and strobili reproductive structure. Cone axis with two opposite bracts. Flower-like structure in collar form of bracts. Male cone, flower arranged alternatively in definite rings. Each flower contains two coherent bracts for perianth. At maturity, stalk elongate such that anther comes out of perianth sheath. Female cone, 4 to 10 ovules above collar. Ovules consist of nucellus surrounded by three envelope. Nucellus consists of central mass of cells. Inner envelope elongates to form micropylar tube. Stomata, scleroids and laticiferous cells form in other two envelopes. Ovules are anatropous, angiospermic character. microsporangium and microsporogenesis. Two archisporial cells divides to form multicell archisporium. Archisporium divide periclinally forming outer layer, that is parietal cells, inner layer sporogenous cell. Parietal cells form capital cells periclinally. Sporogenous cells are cells divided irregularly forming microspore mother cell. Papital cells get binucleated. Microspore mother cell forms haploid microspores by meiosis soon, and papital cells of tapetum disorganize. As soon as the anthers dehisces along the double row of small cells which extend from tip towards the base, the microspores are released. Megasporangium and megasporogenesis. Two archisporial cells divide periclinally forming outer parietal cell and inner sporogenous cells. Primary parietal cells and epidermal cells divide periclinally and anticlinally many times forming new cells. Sporogenous cells by repeated division from megaspore mother cells. Megaspore mother cell by meiosis form tetrasporic embryo sac, out of which one remain functional, other degenerate. Finally, female gametophyte is formed, which is broader at micropylar end, tapering at chalazal end. In netum, normal archegonia, megaspore tetrads are absent. Pollination, fertilization, and post-fertilization. Pollination, pollen pollinated by anemophili get entangled to fluid secreted by micropylar tube, thereby male gametes reach egg chamber. Fertilization, pollen tube break into ovule, releasing male cells. One cell enter egg cell, male and female nuclei lie side by side for some time, then fuse to form a zygote. Endosperm formation. In natum, cellular endosperm is formed after fertilization, although cell formation starts after fertilization. Usually, in gymnosperm, endosperm develop before fertilization. After fertilization, wall formation starts from base and proceed upward such that cytoplasm divide into many compartments containing many nuclei which fuse to form a single nuclei. The upper portion usually remain free nuclear while lower portion become cellular having multi-nucleate compartment. The vice versa may also be possible, and in some rare cases no wall formation may be takes place. Triple fusion found in angiosperm is absent. Embryo in natum. In natum, different species shows variable embryonal development. In Maheshwari and Marsil, the first division of zygote in angiosperm is accompanied by wall formation, while in gymnosperm, except in Sequoia species, free nuclear division. Thus, natum in this respect forms a link between gymnosperm and angiosperm, as it shows both free nuclear division and cell division. As in Madhulata, in natum pneumon, out of 2 to 4 zygote, one remain functional, develop and tubular outgrowth, out of which only one receive nucleus while other disintegrate. The surviving outgrowth of primary suspensor tube pile around each other. A small cell cuts off at the tip of primary suspensor tube, divides first transverse and then longitudinal, giving 4 cells which divide to form cell mass. Some of its cells elongated to form secondary suspensor tube, while other cells form embryonal mass. The primary and secondary suspensor helps in pushing embryo to endosperm to the end of pushing step tip, with 2 lateral cotyledon is formed at tip of embryonal mass, while root tip with root cap is formed at opposite side. Thereafter, feeder develop between the root and shoot portions such that the resultant mature embryo consists of stem tip, root cap in respective sequences. germination of seed in natum. Seeds in natum, oval shape, green to brown in color, surrounded by three-layered envelope enclosing embryo and endosperm. Inner envelope, parenchymatous. Middle envelope, hard, protective. Outer envelope, fleshy, parenchymatous, colored. Seed germination, epigeal type. Hypocotyl, elongate, bringing cotyledon out of soil. First pair of foliage leaves produced by developed plumule. This is life cycle of natum. The resemblances between natum and angiosperm. Following features are common in natum and angiosperm. First, reticulate venation in leaves, presence of xylem vessel, tetrasporic development of female gametophyte, absence of archegonia, and dicot nature of embryo. Resemblances between natum and gymnosperm. Following features are common in natum and gymnosperm. Presence of wood with tracheids having border pips. Presence of anemophily mode of pollination. Presence of naked ovule. Absence of ovary, thus fruit absent. Development of prothallial cell. And presence of cleavage polyembryony. Thank you.